In this video, we're going to look at how to describe a function as a mapping. We have a set of all the inputs that yield an output, which is known as the domain, and that set of corresponding outputs is called the range. The way a function works is it maps some point in the domain to some point in the range. So the blue line is representing the function. Let's take a specific example. Let's say we had y equals x squared, and that 2 is in our domain. Then our function will map 2 to 4, which is in our range. Another way of representing this is as an ordered pair, 2, 4. In general, if we have some function y equals f of x, we would represent the points in our domain with x, which gets mapped to y by our function f. So once again, that blue line is representing f. F is the process of going from an element in the domain to an element in the range. And once again, we can represent this with an ordered pair. Now, for multiple inputs in the domain, we get multiple outputs in the range. In fact, we could have multiple inputs in the domain mapped to a single output in the range, and that still matches our definition of function because each input does have a unique output. Where we'll see the definition of function break down is if we have an input mapped to separate outputs. This does not meet our definition of function, and thus what we have now is no longer a function. But if we remove that, we have a mapping diagram that is in fact a function because it meets our definition of function, which says that each input must have a unique output. And this is just an example of how we can use a mapping to represent a function.